I'm here on behalf of Women's Aid. I'm an ambassador for Women's Aid, and I know certainly the producers of this film and have been in touch with Women's Aid in terms of trying to help them out for the fantastic work that Women's Aid do. And I got in touch with Women's Aid myself, working on a TV project about 5 years ago, and I know the magnificent work they do, and I'm here to help support them, really.
For anyone who isn't familiar with the wonderful work they do, can you just tell us a little bit about what Women's Aid actually does?
Yeah, Women's Aid is a charity, and they look after the victims and survivors of domestic violence. And the film that we're all here to see tonight, A Thousand Kisses Deep, is very much themed on that. I haven't seen it yet. I'm just about to go in, and I'm looking forward to it. Immensely got some fantastic actors in it, and De Grey Scott and Emilia Fox, and some fantastic people. So, Women's Aid, basically, domestic violence is in this country is one of the kind of great hidden truths. You know, one in four women in their lifetime are likely to bump into it through no fault of their own, and one in ten women in any given year. So, that's what I'm here to do, is really to try and raise awareness of it, and that's why I'm at this premiere tonight.
How vital a role do you feel films like this can have in raising awareness and tackling some of the social stigma attached to this very sensitive subject?
I think anything that can raise awareness of it is a good thing. I think with a film, you're really looking to tell a story and to make a good bit of work, and then anything over and above that comes off the back of it. Certainly for Women's Aid, in terms of raising awareness of domestic violence, is a good and useful thing. But certainly, if you're making a film, the most important thing is that you make a good film. Do you know what I mean? And then after that, it's whatever awareness you can raise. But just across all media, really, it's just one of those stories. Domestic violence that tends to only hit the headlines when something very extreme happens, in terms of extreme physical violence. But the vast majority of domestic violence is much more insidious than that. It's much more subtle than that. It can be psychological, it can be financial, it can be emotional, and it can be physical too. But in terms of it's the reason it's why it's such a big problem is that a lot of it goes unnoticed, and a lot of it happens behind closed doors and is to all intents and purposes invisible.
We're big supporters of Childline, the national UK helpline for young people, aimed at helping them to cope with adversity, difficult emotions, difficult situations. What advice would you give to anyone who is currently dealing with these kinds of issues, domestic violence?
To get in touch with somebody. Even if you try and speak to friends if you can, and just find out a number of people who are on the receiving end of domestic violence may not even realise that that's what's going on, because it can be quite an insidious and subtle process over years, sort of gradually wearing you down. And it's just to, firstly, to talk to friends and to get an outside eye on what is happening to you. And secondly, always to get in touch with Women's Aid, who are on a sort of 24-hour-a-day helpline, and will be only too willing to help you get out of the situation, whatever situation you find yourself in.
If people do want to get in touch with Women Aid, what kind of, contact, you mentioned there's a helpline, do you have a number for that, and is there a website?
Yes, there is. www.womensaid.org. .uk is the website, and I don't have the number for me at the moment but
I'm sure they can find it on the website.
It's all Googleable, and it's all out there. So whatever happens, if you think you might be the victim of domestic violence, do get in touch.